Hello, I'm Thoracious Appetite. So the manual for the MicroFreak is really sparse when it comes to covering the digital oscillators, and specifically what the different parameters do. And so I'm going to use an oscilloscope to kind of show very clearly what the parameters do at what values. And then I'm going to demonstrate how you would accomplish a number of traditional analog-style synthesizer techniques with these non-traditional controls. So in this video, I'm going to cover the oscillator types that are useful for analog-style patches, which are the BasicWaves, SuperWave, Virtual Analog, and to some degree, the Sawx. So the BasicWaves, with the first dial, which is called Morph Here and Wave Here, with that at zero, it gives you a square wave, and then as you dial it up, at 50, it's a saw wave. Then as you dial it past 50, it gives you a second saw wave. You can see it fades in here. And because it's 180 degrees out of phase with the other one, once you fully fade it in, halfway in the middle of the other saw wave, it's creating basically a new saw wave that has double the frequency. Okay. Then the second control here is called sim, timbre down here, sim up here. And what that does on the square wave, it modulates the pulse width. From at 50, it's just a square wave, and then all the way, it goes up to 95 for a very wide pulse width. And then on the saws, it changes the relative phase between the two saw waves. So at 95, they're nearly in phase with one another. And then all the way down to 50, they're 180 degrees out of phase with one another. And then you can see clearly here the shape is just it's called sub. It just adds a sine wave one octave below. So you can see for one cycle of the sine wave, there's two of the pulses. And so that's why it's an octave lower. And so one trick you might use here is you might just patch the LFO to the what's called timbre here, but it's the symmetry, it's the pulse width. And that gives you a pretty fat bass. And you can do the same, it sounds pretty similar on the saw. Well, there's the two saws out of phase. Actually, you can use this for like a pad as well. Maybe it's a little less stuff. When you increase the rate, you can hear how the second saw wave is kind of having its pitch modulated up and down to go in and out of phase. Alright, so that's the basic wave. Let's check out the next oscillator type, the super wave. So with the super wave, you have the option of a saw, square, triangle, and sine. And basically what the super wave does is adds multiple waves, and I'm counting around 7 additional waves. And then by detuning them, it creates this really lush sort of super unison sound of having just a bunch of saw waves layered just a little out of tune with one another. And this is a sound you'd hear in like 90s or 2000s kind of Euro dance music, I guess. Like, kind of thing, with a ton of reverb on it, but it's also useful for like pads. like string pads. And yeah, the other waveforms sound great as pads as well. Sorry, I'm clipping here. Cool stuff. All right, so the next oscillator type is the virtual analog. This one's the most difficult to wrap your head around, I think. It's there's two oscillators, one controlled by these two knobs and one controlled by this one. And so this one you can detune. And you can go all the way from F50, it's in tune with the middle, with this oscillator, and down to 25, you're an octave below. At 0, you're 2 octaves below. 75, you're an octave above, and 100, you're 2 octaves above. And get this one out of the way for a second. You can see that this guy, and the shape is shape, which is called wave here, not to be confused with the wave dial, is at 0, you get a triangle. And as you go up to 50, it morphs into a saw wave. And then once you pass 50, you start getting, it's like a pulse width type of thing. And so you, around 75, you're halfway a pulse wave and then half a saw wave, and then as you keep going it completes the pulse all the way down to nothing. And the other guy is just a square wave at 50, and then as you go down from 50 it also does pulse width. Oops. And then as you go up, it's doing the overtones that you would get if you were hard syncing to another oscillator and changing the pitch. And it's not actually hard syncing to this oscillator. As you can hear, changing the detune doesn't do anything, but it's just hard syncing to an imaginary third oscillator. So some you can do the same trick with the pulse width modulation. You can on this region of this wave, you can just patch the LFO to the so the assign one is always by default already patched to the third control here, so we can. With modulation on this oscillator. And then likewise you can do pulse width modulation on this oscillator. I'll just put this somewhere around the middle and modulate this control with the LFO. Right, and then there's one other trick you can do on this guy, is this region up here. So if you set the shape to around 50, then you can create like an envelope to modulate the sync. So you patch the envelope to the timbre, crank that a bit. Dial you dial in a saw wave an octave below. So that kind of covers the functions of this oscillator. Let's see. And finally, there's the Sawx. And the way I think of the Sawx is it's kind of like a combination between the sync of the square wave from the virtual analog oscillator and the super saw, in that when you change the saw mod here, oops, too much volume. You see, it adds these overtones, like the hard sync overtones. So again, you can patch an envelope into that and get. If you want. And then the second thing that's going on here is that if you turn up the timbre dial, which in this is called shape, not to be confused with shape, it adds copies. It's called chorus in the manual, but this is not what chorus sounds like. A chorus is usually modulated by an LFO, a low-frequency oscillator, which gives it a gentle detune. But this doesn't really detune enough, and it's modulated by noise. And the fundamental saw is also modulated by the noise, which in chorus you have one that's just stable, and then you have the duplicates that modulate. So it's not really a chorus. It sounds a little more like a flange or something, but it doesn't really sound like unison either. So I don't know. I don't know what you would call it. But that's this guy. I don't have any other tricks for it besides the sync. And I hope that was useful to somebody. And I hope that wasn't too long or too short. Feel free to leave comments. And I'm going to have some more content about this synthesizer. And I've been working a bunch on updates for my patch bank for this guy. So stay tuned for that. And if you have any requests for sounds that you want me to add to that patch bank, send them my way. Or if you have requests for sounds you'd like me to demonstrate how you synthesize, send those my way as well.